this afternoon. Let's update you now on the top stories here on Sky News and the parents of the missing schoolgirl.
Pero el rey del rock sigue siendo inmortal. Lo mantienen en vida las decenas de miles de admiradores que han celebrado una vigilia en Graceland, la mansión del cantante en Memphis, Tennessee, por el aniversario de su muerte. Si no lo sientes, si no tienes a Elvis en tu vida, significa que no vives, afirma este incondicional. Con Elvis cambió la forma de hacer música, de vestir y de comportarse en los escenarios. El cantante murió tal día como hoy, a los 42 años, de una sobredosis de medicamentos. Pero el mito sigue vivo y sigue barriendo en las listas de ventas. Cada año gana 40 millones de euros en derechos de autor por canciones como esta.
Love me sweet, never let me go. Thou made my life complete, and I love you so.
In a quarter century after his death, a live report now from Jonathan Cerri, who is clearly feeling the spirit. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, John. Well, as you can see, there's a lot of Elvis spirit going on here at Graceland. You love these glasses. You know, this is one of the best-selling items out here. The best is when you run into people with blonde hair wearing these dark sideburns. I was going to try to convince you that these were real sideburns, that I've grown them when I was away in Afghanistan, but couldn't pull it off. Anyway, there is Elvis spirit going on here despite some horrible weather. Look at this rain behind me here at Graceland. Even so, many people came out with candles for last night's candlelight vigil, one that went throughout the night.
25 years after Elvis Presley's death, thousands of fans converge on Graceland, Presley's home and final resting place. A week-long tribute to the king of rock and roll, attracting pilgrims of pop culture from around the world.
I came for Elvis. I only came for Elvis.
Yeah. All the way from Holland.
Yeah, of course. It was like 10 hours, a little bit of a jet lag, but it was worth every minute of it.
I love him. I think he's marvelous, and I don't think he'll ever die.
So he's still alive?
Yeah, he is.
Where is he?
Memphis.
Please, we'll do anything that you want to do. But
the King's legacy continues to inspire new generations of fans and impersonators.
Well, you can do anything, but take me over my blue suede shoes. Let's go, Ken!
Elvis a whole lot. Big Elvis fan.
What do you like best about Elvis?
He gets the girls.
Elvis is never too busy to oblige his young admirers.
He had a lot of life. A lot of life and vitality. I like the way he moves.
Qualities many have tried to imitate.
I love you.
Are those natural sideburns?
Took me a long time to grow them and a longer time to dye them that way. Yes, sir, they are.
I don't care how good of a impersonation you can do, you'll never be Elvis. God only ever made one. Nobody will ever be Elvis.
And that is why adoring fans continue coming out to Graceland even 25 years later. Now, before we go, I'd like to pop up a picture of a supermarket tabloid that we came in contact with. John Scott, you care to explain this? I understand that
I should have burned
I'm not the
all
only
the
Elvis
copies.
Impersonator here, yeah?
Yeah, I should have burned all the copies. I did a little piece on the Weekly World News a while back, and they doctored that photo. Believe it or not,
Twin
they
brother,
actually
eh?
Doctored that photo. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to. All right, I'll get you for that one, Cerri.
All right.
They're really embracing this. I mean, some people think it might be a little bit, you know, tacky to keep commemorating, you know, the week that Elvis died, after all. But they're really embracing this down there, aren't they?
Yeah, John, you know, this is one of the things that makes America great. We are famous for our shrines. We love holding shrines for people. And you'd think that a lot of people would be coming out of here enjoying sort of the cheesiness of the situation. But you come up close and personal with these Elvis fans, and they're visiting his gravesite with all the sincerity that you would have expected out of them as if he had just died yesterday. They're taking this extremely seriously.
What's the most interesting Elvis trivia or most surprising Elvis, memento you've learned there this week, Jonathan?
Well,
I think the most amazing thing is just when you consider how old he would be if he were still alive. 67. You look at all those old pictures of the young, youthful Elvis, both from the 60s and even the Elvis from the 70s. And, you know, it's amazing when you look at some of his contemporaries who are considerably older than the pictures that you would see.
Wow. Elvis at 67. Hmm. Jonathan Seri, thank you. I'll get you for that picture, buddy.
Okay.
Straight ahead. We're going to talk with the man who actually coined the phrase, Elvis has left the building. And it seems it's not enough.
And I'll always hold you from the cold Kentucky rain.
The Presley blessing ceremony at the Winter Gardens in Blackpool was the couple's prize in a radio competition.
Oh, it's so nice seeing all these people in the costumes.
Congratulations, my darling.
Thank you.
Rule our lives, and we don't have shrines in the house. You know, there's a lot of people out there who are Elvis booked. You know, we like the music, and that's it, really.
Afterwards, a limousine to the airport and a flight to Vegas for a full Presley wedding. 25 years after his death, the King is more popular today than during his years of stardom. Elvis lookalike Mark Lean from County Kerry was just 6 when Presley died.
I think it's fantastic. 99% of Elvis's fans never saw him play live. So, you know, we're here to give them that kind of live experience, to get a scarf or a kiss from Elvis or whatever it is they want.
The Presley legacy could mean big business for resorts like Blackpool, which is staging a huge Elvis Presley convention here this weekend. Blackpool wants to become the Las Vegas of the North, and that could mean more Elvis Presley events in the years to come. Trevor Green, Sky News, Blackpool.
Very good Trevor Green impersonator there. I don't know about the others too.
You're watching Sky News, coming up on the sport with Alec Wilson, including the latest from the US PGA Championship.
Es al delegado de la...